I'm Shani Ojukwu-Mantenso. Welcome to Hadiya Movement Systems. We're going to do a Hadiya yoga session today. You can call me Shani Om, Dr. Om. Thank you for joining me. So all you need for your practice today is your sticky mat, and you may also want a block or a brick. And if you have two, better, but if you have one, that's perfect. And if you don't even have that, if you have you can use a sweatshirt or a sweater or a blanket that you can roll up. We might use under our hips at certain points or under our knees. And you can even implement that now. So I'm on top of one of them. If you want to raise your hips above your knees in your Sukhasana easy pose, seated here, my legs are folded in, as you can see. You can have yours out, whatever feels good to you. It is supposed to be an easy pose. The idea is that you have comfort while you have your spine stacked on itself. So from the sacrum all the way up to the skull. Okay, so sitting nice and tall, we'll start by attuning ourselves to the space, and then we'll start our asana practice. So I have my Tibetan singing bowl right here. We're going to take a couple breaths together. So sitting nice and tall, hands on your knees, your thighs, in your lap, whichever you prefer. My eyes are closed, yours can be closed, soft, or wide open, whatever feels safe and comfortable for you in this moment. I'm lowering my chin just a little bit toward the chest, elongate that upper spine, that cervical spine. Taking a couple breaths here together to attune to the space. We're here together for our yoga practice. And always feel free to pause the video and take a longer meditation if you wish before engaging any movement. So keeping the eyes soft, we're going to start by raising our arms overhead. Long, long arms all the way to the ceiling, taking our gaze with us, our drishti. My arms are parallel to one another, my palms are facing each other. Long, long, long side bodies, lengthening as we root into the floor, into the earth. We're lengthening to the ceiling, to the roof, to the sky, to the stars. Good, lower one arm down by your side, up and over, side body stretch. Keeping that hip down, so I'm leaning my left with my right arm. Either side is fine, we're doing both sides, but keeping that right hip down. I'm taking my gaze under my right arm up to the ceiling. Lowering the shoulders away from the ears so the neck is nice and long. That's a correction for myself as well. Many of us have a tendency to raise those shoulders up. Good, coming back, upright, raising that left arm to meet the right again. Good, now I'm lowering my right arm down to my mat. And then nice and long, lengthen, lengthen, and then over to the right side, taking my gaze under my left arm up to the ceiling, moving those shoulders away from the ear, keeping my left hip grounded into the block, the brick, the mat, the earth. Good. Breathing in and breathing out. Always breathing. Coming around to the center. Finding those fingertips on the floor. Walking your fingertips away from the body. And we're going to keep going until our hips want to peel off the mat or the brick. That's where we want to stop. Good, and then lower our elbows toward the floor, and then lower the chin toward the chest. Long, long
backside body from our seated position. That whole spine is long. Breathing in and breathing out, always breathe in. Remember, yoga means union, mind, body, and spirit.
Using the breath as a vehicle to move that life force, that ashe, that prana through the body. Good, my right hand is going to my left thigh. Sitting up nice and tall, my left fingertips are behind me. Rooting into the mat. A nice seated spiral twist toward the back of the room. Feel like you're being pulled by the crown of your head up to the ceiling. Looking over that left shoulder, if you wish, in order to deepen the stretch. Working with the body, listening to the body, honoring the body's cues. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Coming back to center, same thing on the other side. My left hand to my right thigh. My right fingertips behind me, sit up nice and tall, rooting and lengthening at the same time. And then spiral toward the back of the room, taking your gaze with you if you would like. Just a light invitation. Accept or decline any invitation that's called instruction. It's your practice, your body. In this moment, not your body yesterday, last week, or last year. Coming back to center, very good, good. So we're gonna find ourselves off of the block or brick. We're gonna find our tabletop position, taking some cat-cows, our full spinal cord breath. So with the breath, we're gonna move into those two positions and out of those two positions. So my hands are right under my shoulders, knees under my hips, feet right behind my knees. Starting with our cow, always start with the cow. Taking the inhale, tucking the toes, lowering the pelvis, raising the chest and chin. Exhale, our cat. So coordinating with the breath, inhale, our Vasisthasana, our cow. Really exaggerate the movement. See if you can get your eyes all the way up to that ceiling. Exhale, our cat, Marjaryasana. Inhale, our cow. Take a couple more of these at your own pace. Again, trying to line up the breath with the movement. Cat-cow offers up a beautiful opportunity to do that because it's fairly simple movement. But the idea is to coordinate the breath with the body in all of our yoga postures and sequences. Good, and we're gonna take one more cat wherever you are. You can meet me at the neutral tabletop position. Very nice, good. We're gonna take our puppy pose. So the knees are gonna go back a little bit. Keeping the arms nice and long out in front of us. Lengthening that whole upper body. Long, long arms. So we're sending our tail up to the ceiling as we lower our chin toward the mat. Good, long, long spine. So we know what our intention is, right? Whether we achieve whatever, you know, that destination, that target is or not, is not the point. It's our intention. It's our effort. Breathing in and out through that upper body, opening up the chest, the shoulders. As we breathe, long, long spine. Good, very nice. Now we're gonna thread the needle from here. So we're gonna flip our right palm up to the ceiling, draw that elbow into the body, And then let the arm go through and under the left arm, keeping the palm up, going all the way through to the shoulder, to the right ear. Lengthening both arms, keeping the tail up to the ceiling. Breathing in and breathing out. Good. Coming back, so drawing that arm back into the body and extending it out to meet the left arm. Good, finding the little puppy again. Good, let's flip the left palm up to the ceiling. Draw that elbow into the body. And then let it go through the right arm, keeping that palm up to the ceiling, all the way to the left shoulder, the left ear. Good, our little puppy dog. Long arms, long spine. Breathing in and breathing out, drawing that arm back into the body. And overhead, very nice, good. Coming back up to our tabletop position. Beautiful, beautiful. So we're gonna find our down dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. So wide fingers, knees hip width apart. That's how I prefer to do mine. But however you like, if you like your feet together, that's fine too. Go ahead and bring the knees and feet together. But if you like them right under the hips, you can leave them there. Tucking the toes behind you on your next big exhale. Send the hips up and back. You can pedal out the feet a little bit. Waking up the ankles, the heels, the feet, the calves. Finding those heels toward the mat. So if they don't really want to go there, you can bend the knees a little, you can walk your feet in. However you can make contact with the mat, your heels and the mat. Your gaze can either be between your feet or your knees. Long, long arms. Good. Sending those shoulders back, back, back. Good. Very nice. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good. We're gonna find our Malasana, our plank pose. Sending those shoulders forward over our hands. Good. We're going to take modified side plank, or we can take it full side plank. So we're going to go over, put all of our weight to the right side of the body. Good. My back is going to be to you for a moment. Good. Find the top of that side foot. So here's the full expression. But if that's not in your practice today, go ahead and lower that right knee and be nice and long here. Okay, but the idea is to be on the one side of the body in your plank pose. My left arm is straight up to the ceiling. I'm looking up at my left thumb. So wherever you are in the modification or in the fuller expression, you can go even farther, lifting and elongating that left leg. But either place, breathing in and breathing out. Good. We're going to come back to our center plank pose. And the same thing on the other side. So either the knee down or up. So this time I think I'll stay up, placing the weight on the left side of the body, keeping the feet flexed, lengthening through the whole right side of the body and left, both sides. I'm looking up at my right thumb, keeping those feet flexed, engaging the abdomen. Breathing in and breathing out, long side body. Good. And coming back to your plank position. Very nice. Good. Good. And now we're going to take our Ashtanga 8 point. Eight limbs, whatever it is, but you know Ashtanga. So we're here in our Malasana. I'm separating my feet a little bit. Good. So we're gonna lower the knees. Very nice. Then we're gonna lower the chest. So send the elbows back, 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 and the bottom up, up, up. Lowering the chest to the mat. Good, and our last point, our eighth point, is our chin. So we're looking forward, elbows are back and into the body. My hips are up. So if we count our eight, our two toes, our two balls of our feet, our two hands, our two knees, right, that makes six, and then our chest and chin make seven and eight. Good. We're gonna push through into our low cobra. Nice and low. Nice and low. Hands are right under our shoulders. Our legs are squeezed together. We're looking forward. Breathing in and breathing out. And notice the difference in your breathing, right? So you're lying on top of your lungs. So it requires a little more effort. You may bob up and down as you breathe. Letting the body flow with its natural processes. Inhale and exhale. Good, now we're gonna lift our hands up just a half an inch or an inch, right where they are, so everything else stays. Noticing the body. Noticing that you need to engage the muscles around the spine even more. A little more efforting, a little more muscle. Good. Inhaling and exhale. Go ahead and put the hands back down. Good. We're going to slide back a little bit into our sphinx. Okay, so to our forearms. Good. So instead of using the hands, or just the belly and chest, we're using those forearms, still squeezing those legs together behind us, legs and feet are together. Pressing into the mat with our forearms and palms. Long neck, looking forward. Always looking forward. Good. Rooting into the mat as we ascend upward. Very nice. Good, good, good. Good. Okay, so let's make our way to our feet. So lower the chest. Put the hands under the shoulders again. Press ourselves up through our tabletop position. Good. We're going to find our downward facing dog. Tucking the toes, lifting the hips. Good. Staying here for a moment. Long arms, long legs. The hips are all the way up to the ceiling. Good. Breathing in and breathing out. See if you can make contact with those heels. Think of lifting your toes. It probably won't happen, but that's a nice inner directive. Now look between your hands. We're gonna walk our feet nice and slowly. Soft, soft knees between our hands. We're gonna hang over for a moment. So replacing our hands with our feet. Hip width apart. Soft knees. Bent enough so that your belly rests on your thighs. So if you need to bend them even more, go ahead please. Heavy arms, neck, shoulders, and head. You can shake your head yes. You can shake your head no. Good. All of the weight is released and allowed. Good. Our 2.5 pound bowling balls we carry around our neck and shoulders. Allow that to be below the heart and the lungs. Good. Very good for our nervous system and our circulatory systems. Good. So if you feel a little tension in the lower back, you can place your hand, one hand or two hands there, because we're going to unroll to stand. And sometimes there can be pressure doing that. If not, keep your arms heavy. But
go ahead and tuck the tail and take your time with bent knees, unrolling to stand. Engage that abdomen, draw the navel into the front of the spine. Heavy arms, heavy head. Good. Take your time, one vertebra at a time. Luxuriate over that movement. It should feel good, it does to me. Good, okay, coming to center, finding our pranamasana. All right, we're gonna do a little bit standing together. Okay, a couple of standing poses. All right, so one of the things I want us to do Padmasana, okay? Half Padmasana standing, okay? So let's check out our feet, right? Because all standing poses, all centering poses, you want to be really rooted into the ground, into the floor, and with as much a broad of a base as possible. So I like to raise and separate my toes and place them back down, okay? So right here where we are, we're gonna pick up our right heel, okay? And find a focus in front of you, okay? That also helps with any kind of movement or teetering or anything like that. We're gonna lift that leg, and we're gonna find our half Padmasana. So I'm bringing my heel into my groin, and then the top of that foot upward. So it may take a couple of adjustments here. And then let the knee fold down. Find the top of that foot. That helps. Good. And now I'm going to let go with my right arm and let it come behind my back and find my left bicep. And if it's not in your practice, then it's not in your practice. If it is, then it is. So finding some stillness in the body and the mind. Good. Breathing into the pose. Into the challenge of the pose. If you come out of it, come out of it. And then sequentially come back into it. Breathing in and breathing out. Finding a softness around the effort, around the challenge. If you'd like to take that right arm above your head, slowly, please feel free. I'm taking a little mudra. Index finger to thumb. Breathing in, breathing out. Good. Giving ourselves a couple more breaths wherever you are. Your Ardha Padmasana, standing Ardha Padmasana. Good. Good. And sequentially start finding your original position, coming out. Very nice. Good. Okay, so shaking those legs, we're going to do the other side. Good. Okay. So checking out your foundation again, raising and separating those toes. The other side. Good. So I'm lifting my left heel now. Standing tall, standing strong, really rooting. Good, finding that spot in front of you, right? So go ahead and raise the leg and find it in your hand. So the heel and the groin. Good, and now holding the top of the foot with the opposite hand. Good, so the bottom of the foot can be turned upward as I lower the knee down. Good, opening the chest, opening that heart. Good, I'm gonna take that arm around back behind me and I'm gonna find my opposite bicep so I can open the chest even further. Drawing in that navel, always, always engaging that third chakra when we're standing, really all the time, but definitely when we're standing. Manipura, that core, that solar plexus. Good. Making little adjustments as you go. If you're going with me for that third part of the sequence, we're gonna raise the arm overhead.
with or without the mudra. Long and tall. So we're rooting and lengthening, right? The idea, you're going in opposite directions, right? Like a tree, deep, deep roots and tall, tall branches all the way to the sky. Finding peace, finding grace, finding ease in the challenge. Good. We're gonna lower that arm and then release the leg. Good. Supposed to do that one standing pose. We're gonna go down to the floor. So shaking the legs out, but we're gonna go down with Garland Pose with Malasana. So separating those feet beyond hip width apart, turning the feet outward. Our knees are gonna follow the trajectory of our feet. Let's go ahead and find Padmasana again. Palms together, heart center, thumbs right at our sternum. So the idea is to squat right down. So remember that breaker block. If you need or want that, let's grab that first. Right, one or two, if it's a sweatshirt, a sweater, a blanket, a pillow, whatever. But I want you to be able to sit, okay? I want you to be able to sit in that squat all the way down, okay? But safely, okay? And comfortably, there should not be pain. Even if there's a little challenge, a little discomfort even, there should not be pain. Stop if there's pain. Okay, so if we have our setup, whatever our setup is for us today, go ahead and lower yourself down, the knees going over the feet, over the toes. Not in, not anything like that. Straight down. So maybe I wanted another block or something. Where is it? There it is. Good. Good. Using the elbows and the triceps to press those legs outward. Sitting up nice and tall, chest is open, heart is open. Anahata, our fourth chakra, right at the center of our seven primary chakras. Heart centered, heart opened. Good, and this is good for our hips, good for our digestive systems. Good, very nice. Always breathing, continuous breathing. Good. And coming out of this pose as gracefully as possible, we're gonna find our Supasana again to close our session together. So I'm gonna cross my legs, pull my legs in. Good. Thank you so much for joining me. And if for you, if you would like to end with the traditional ending, which is, Shavasana, please do. Otherwise, or you can do that, just pause and come back for our closing together. Good, you did a beautiful job. I'm so grateful, thankful that you joined me on your mat today. And you know, keep flowing and keep moving and gentle. That whole no pain is no gain, that's so long ago. It never should have been, but at least since the 80s. We didn't need to do that, right? So we can work with our bodies and our minds and our spirits and still grow and expand and exercise and become healthy and fit without any pain. That's not necessary. We don't have to do that to ourselves. Let's find our Pranamasana together. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm Shani Om. The light in me honors the light.